Hello friends, today I am going to create UML diagram inside the NetBean. Basically friends, when we are developing software, then there are four phases bothered that like analysis, design, coding and testing. Four important phases are there. So whenever we are going to create any projects students are going to create any project, then they are not understanding that in which way they have to create UML diagram and what is the relationship of this UML diagram with your programming. So that is okay, we know how to make the UML diagram in any simple tool, or manually they can be created, or ER diagram can be created manually, and you can prepare the flow charts etc manually, and you are doing the analysis manually. But particularly this video for the students of BTech, BCA or MCA, those are going to create projects, so they have to understand particularly then in which way UML diagrams can be created and how to make the relationship of such type of UML diagrams with the coding. So they are particularly for the purpose of modeling, and they are UML diagrams are supporting two types of modeling. One type of modeling is structural modeling, and another type is behavioral modeling. So today we are going to discuss how to do structural modeling, and then how to create classes of that UML diagram automatically. So NetBean is a very beautiful IDE and very good IDE, excellent IDE that is supporting such type of things. And you can create your UML diagrams, your class diagrams, and just by a single click all the classes will be created. Just you have to concentrate on your own logic. So for that purpose, first of all you have to download Easy UML from a site, and that site is available there. You can see Easy UML can be downloaded as a plugin. After downloading that plugin, you have to go in NetBean, and in NetBean there is a option tool and inside tool plugin, and after that you will be seeing then available plugins and downloads. So whatever plugin you have downloaded, like I am going to download this one, so it will be taking some time. And now you have to go here, and because already I downloaded that one, so 149983, just 149983, 149983 I downloaded that. So you can extract that, but it is available in the form of folder with me, so I can go to that place, and it is available on my NetBean already, so I am not going to install that once more, and I am not going to delete. So just you have to see that folder is available, 14, so I think it is there. So after extracting, you will be seeing so many NBM file there, all are the NetBean plugins. So now go inside the NetBean and add plugin, and then you will be seeing that so many plugins are there, but my plugin exactly is available in download folder, and that is 14, and this is Easy UML. So just click on that, just click on it, and then select all such files there and just open it, and that will be installed successfully after opening, and you have to follow the instructions, so plugin will be installed. After installation of this plugin, you have to go on new project, and then you will be seeing what I have to create. So you are seeing UML there, it will be available only after the installation of Easy UML. So I am going to create that. Any other option is there? No, it is okay. So UML diagram I am selecting, and just finish. Okay, so now in UML diagrams you are looking class diagram at one folder is there. So I am clicking here, and I am creating one more Easy UML diagram. So, or you can come here and now create new others. Okay, go to unit test available 2 times. Easy UML is not there. I think it should be available. UML diagrams. Select Selenium, AWT, Glassfish, why not easy UML is there? UML diagrams I created, inside that I created so many other things. Now new and diagram for database, entity class, GPA modular, persistent unit, executable, applet, test for existing class, JSP. Just I will be checking. I think no is UML. I think I created a wrong project. Now once more go and see only UML is there or is UML is also there. So only is UML is there. Once more I am creating. Okay, we will be seeing that what is the problem, that UML and UML and project name is just test, T-E-S-T, test UMLDIG. Okay, so I am going to create that one. So test new, give name entity class. New entity class I am going to create, test, test. So entity class is to be created, test. Project have no source folder configuration property. Okay, just wait. Folder class diagram. Okay. So unit test persistence. Okay, that is wrong. So what I have to do, new UML. It is there. So class diagram I have to create. Okay, now I am right. So once more friends, you can see I created this project from the UML category, and now I am going there and then I am going to others, and then you are seeing easily class diagram UML is there. Just I will click on that and I will be selecting name test, test UML, and just click on finish. Okay, now you will be seeing CDG file is there. And now in this CDG file you can see easily that what type of things are to be created. So just I am creating one class, you have to just pick up from this place. I am saying my class name is student. Okay, and what type of things are there, like I am saying int, int en is there, int enrollment number is there. Okay, and as I am saying another variable is int age is there. Okay, now I am saying that one more thing that can be created, add constructor method. So I am going to add one method, and method name is just void, void void display display en. I am going to display enrollment number. So it is okay, and just I created a very small class, and exactly in same way if you want to create a teacher class, then you can go and you can say this is teacher teacher class is there, and just I am saying that string string sub sub, what subject a teacher is teaching, as what subject is teacher is teaching. So string string sub. So just I am writing that. Okay, so just string string subject subject. Okay, now just I am making one function void, void display display sub. So I am going to display what subject he is teaching. if you want to create any relationship between these two classes, you can create with the help of such symbols like is, implement and all these. But I am not going to tell everything about this UML diagram this time. My purpose is this, that after creation of such type of UML diagrams, there are so many books are available from that you can study how to create UML diagrams. But my main objective is this, how to make relationship of this UML diagram with your programming, because this is the this is belonging to the design phase, and after that you have to go for the coding phase. So just right click there and then okay, and then right click there, and then there is one option that you have to create easy UML. Okay, right click here, right click here. First, in the first attempt I was right, and just you have to click right click, do right click here, easy UML generate code. So when you are clicking on this, then you will be asked at what place the code of all these classes are to be created, but that will be structural only because we are doing structural modeling. So if you are saying that in some other folder, like I am going to create that in Java application 19, so generate code. Now after going to Java application 19, you can see the complete code has been created for these two classes, but that is only structural. So just go and just see at this place.
हेलो दोस्तों, हमारी वीडियो को लाइक एवं सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें. आपको हमारी वीडियो को लाइक करने के लिए इस आइकन पर क्लिक करना होगा, तथा सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए आपको इस बॉक्स पर क्लिक करना पड़ेगा. आप हमारी वीडियो को सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए इस बेल आइकन पर भी क्लिक कर सकते हैं. इन दोनों का एडवांटेज आपको ये रहेगा कि जब भी हमारी कोई नई एक इंटरेस्टिंग वीडियो आएगी, तो आपके YouTube अकाउंट के टॉप पर बेल आइकन पर एक अलर्ट आ जाएगा.
नॉट टेस्ट पैकेज, डिफाइंड पैकेज, टेस्ट लाइब्रेरीज, डिफॉल्ट पैकेज. ओके, so teacher, so just once more you have to concentrate on your UML diagram, what type of things were available. There were two classes, teacher and student, so two classes must be created, and teacher is having two elements inside the object. One is string subject and display method, and student is having two things. One is the enrollment number, age and display. So two functions must be available inside student class. So finally, abstract is this, teacher class must be created, that will be having one variable and one display method. Student class must be created, that is having one variable and two methods. And at what place we created these two? We created inside Java application 19. Just I am making it bigger and so that you can understand it. So student class has been created, and you can see what is in student class. One enrollment number and two methods are available there. Same for teacher, there are two elements, one is subject and another one is display subject. Now you have to concentrate only on the logic. So this is the advantage of creating UML diagrams in NetBeans. It is directly connecting the coding phase and design phase easily. So till now I did only structural modeling in UML diagram, and I created respective code for that. So thank you friends, I think it will be beneficial for you. Okay, bye.